this order, what you think about, is a 10-foot long brick. Okay? And if you hit it, you're just going to knock yourself out. Okay? Now, the wall starts right here. That's why my foot's here. And what I want you to do is, when you start going, once you're in this position like Mac was talking, over the left and all the weight's on the left leg. See that? Same position Mac was doing, okay? Once I'm in this position, where's my power, my line of power? Right down this left foot right here, into the discus. This is where I want my line of power to be. So what I used to think about is slapping the wall with both hands. There's a wall here. As I went to this position, and as I was creating my orbit to this position, I would hit the wall right here with both hands. Okay? I'm still on this side of the wall. In fact, my right foot is landing here, not even at middle. Once I'm in this position, and I'm here, and this foot comes to here right on the wall, now when I release, I'm right side of the wall. I'm still on this side of the wall. Yes. So, 10-foot wall. In order to stay on this side without whacking your head, you're going to have to get over. Okay? Slap the wall, land right side. It's hard, isn't it? And you want to know why it's hard? Because this is easy, people. This is easy. Okay, if I want to create rotational velocity, that's what we're talking about. Rotational linear velocity, that's distance throwing. If I want to create rotation, I can create all I want with my left arm. I'm doing nothing with my legs. This is all left arm. Okay? Tons of rotation. Just like you just did on that one. But if I stand here and do this, how am I going to move? How can I move? I gotta just like Mac Wilkins, I gotta get my weight on my left. And then I gotta use my right to create the rotation. Where does the rotation come from in the throw? 100%. Pretty much. Right leg. Out of the back. And the hips in the front, yes. But if I'm stuck here, I can't move. Somebody says move. What you guys do is you go, I'm gonna cheat. Move. Okay. Look what that did to me. Broke through the wall, cracked my head open, and I fell this way. So now move. Okay. Get the weight on the left. Move. See how I'm even going this way still? I'm on this side of the wall. Absolutely. Now do that. I want you to move. Last time you used the left arm. You're not going to put your arms behind your back, but
get over my left.
Get over your left so far that then the right takes over and you're on this side of the wall. Look, folks. See the difference? He's now, how much do you weigh? He's now putting 240 pounds and the rotational limit and everything behind the discus now. Whereas if you're 240, you're creating power, and then you decide that you want to land here and land here, behind the discus. I don't know what the percentage would be, but it's not what you want. It's not 100%. It's going to go less. And that move right there is the number one problem with any thrower, including myself. 21 years, I battled this, and I won sometimes. Even after 21 years, I didn't get it right in every throw. It's really hard. Why? Because you have to take the time to do it. And throwing is, go fast, blah, blah, blah. When you watch the professional throwers, like an Adam Nelson or a Cantwell, or if you watch Mac or myself when we throw, we're releasing it just like, blah, blah, and we're just going nuts. But that's because we spent 20 years learning how to set it up right so we can. You guys got to chill out. Learn how to set it up right. Become rhythmic throwers. And then once you have a few years behind your belt and you're used to setting it up consistently, then you can go nuts. Put all your force. That's the problem with YouTube. The greatest thing about YouTube is you guys can go on YouTube and see what it looks like. The worst part about YouTube is you're not me, and you're not Christian Campbell yet, and you're not Chris Hoffa yet, or whoever your person is. And so you watch them throw, and you're like, man, he's going fast. That's the key. Not for you guys. That's the key for me because I spent 20 years setting it up.